The Hungarian Minister of Foreign Affairs is not very happy with Emmanuel Macron. Yes, Emmanuel Macron, France. What's up, everybody? I hope you're doing good. I'm not too well, but I'm good because I love you. I'm here every day for you. Thank you very much for choosing us. I choose you too. Beautiful day. It's the weekend. I see you from all over the place. Dumelang, all South Africans, I greet you. Jebaleko, Basibona Banyabo, Ugandans, I salute you from Kenya, Uganda, Tanzania, Zanzibar, Ghana, Nigeria, Jamaica. Thank you very much. We're going to be very quick because, yeah, we're taking too much time. So the Hungarian Minister of Foreign Affairs has expressed public concern over Emmanuel Macron because Emmanuel Macron has assumed again responsibility and the possibilities of sending troops to Ukraine. So this man is not happy at all. The French President Emmanuel Macron once again assumed the possibility of sending Western ground troop to Ukraine. He says we will have to ask the question if Moscow were to break through the front lines, if there was a Ukrainian request, he insisted. So if Moscow was to break through the Ukrainian front line, we have to ask ourselves questions. And this is just 2 months after he created a controversy by asserting that sending the Western troops in Ukraine should not be ruled out. Okay, here's Macron. Very good looking man, young man, not so young, he's in his 40s though. He's married to, that's his wife? Yeah, that's his wife. So his wife used to be his teacher in school. Yeah, they found out, a student. Interesting. Anyway, that's none of your business. Let's get back to track. So Macron made comments saying that Europeans should be ready. They should not rule out the possibilities of sending troops in Ukraine to fight against the Russians. Putin war in Ukraine has been very rampant and very difficult for Ukrainians. Most Western nations expected Vladimir Putin to lose the war very quickly. But unfortunately, it has not happened that way. So Macron says, I believe we should be ready. We should not rule out the possibilities of sending troops to Ukraine to go and fight. Now, the Hungarian Minister of Foreign Affairs was concerned about this declaration, saying it is threatening. If Europeans and American soldiers set foot on Ukraine soil, it means they will have crossed the line with NATO. If NATO member states send soldiers to Ukraine, it means that there will be a direct confrontation between NATO and Russia. This means Third World War. Hungary is next country to Ukraine. So Hungary is part of NATO.
We are threatened by these statements.
C'est une déclaration que nous trouvons menaçante. En effet, nous vivons juste à côté de cette guerre. Nous sommes un pays voisin et nous savons que s'il y a des troupes sur le terrain, sur le territoire ukrainien, eh bien la guerre va gagner en ampleur. Et cette escalade prend déjà une dimension géographique, hein, c'est-à-dire que ça ne va pas à des milliers de kilomètres. Nous, nous sommes juste à côté, nous sommes un pays voisin et nous ne souhaitons pas que cette guerre escalade. Alors, au lieu de penser à de nouvelles exportations d'armes, au lieu de penser à mettre des soldats sur le terrain ou encore à penser à une utilisation de l'arme nucléaire, il faut mettre un terme à cette guerre, il faut déclarer un cessez-le-feu et les négociations de paix doivent commencer. C'est la seule manière d'avancer, c'est la seule manière d'éviter une nouvelle catastrophe.
If any NATO soldier set foot officially in Ukraine, that's war. The Russian president has said it. That means there's no negotiation anymore. That's war between NATO and Russia.
Україну натовських воєнних контингентів. Но ми пам'ятаємо судьбу тих, хто направляв когда-то свої контингенти на територію нашої країни. Но тепер последствия для возможних інтервентів будуть гораздо більш трагічними.
And I understand that the war between NATO and Russia would engage massive bombs, and those are atomic bombs. This is an atomic bomb. That's an atomic bomb. Do you really want that in your neighborhood? I don't think you do. So the Hungarian minister is being cautious, saying, fellas, we understand you're not happy that Putin is winning the war in Ukraine, or that you are struggling in Ukraine against a country you thought you would crush very quickly. But do you really need to send troops on the ground? I don't think this makes sense.
We do understand that that the longer this war will take, the more people will die and the more destruction will take place. And we also do understand that in this war, Ukraine cannot win over Russia.
That's not his war, right? Ukraine is Ukraine. France is France. Ukraine is Ukraine. France is France. This is Ukraine. And this is France. What do they have in common? Why would the French president feel so adamant, feel so obliged to send troops to Ukraine and try to get other people to join him to go send troops in Ukraine and fight? It's very simple. Now, you know, look at Africa. This is Africa. All these countries were colonized by the French. You see the map? Yes, they were colonized by France for many, many years. France used to beat the living crap out of them. Before colonialism, until up to independence, they asked African countries to sign a paper saying, after independence, equate before independence. So by that they mean, even though colonialism is finished, we are still ruling you. Your economy is within our hand. And that's the reason why they created a currency named the CFA franc for these countries. What's the use of this currency? The use of this currency is to keep France wealthy as a country. After independence, many experts believe that many African presidents in ex-French colonies were just puppets. So France used to choose somebody. Okay, I'll choose someone. You're going to be a president in Ivory Coast. You're going to do things the way we want you to do. If you don't do things the way we want you to do, you're going to be president in Benin. You're going to be president in Togo. No, not you. You are too serious. We don't want you. The other one is more corruptible. You're going to be president in Gabon. That's why you've seen in some countries like Gabon, one family has been president for over 58 years. Yes, that was the policy as per the expert of France in Africa. Now, fellas, in a couple of years that have passed, Mali, Burkina Faso, and Niger have turned the ball against France. They have asked them to leave the countries. They have come into power through coup d'etats, but have taken the power from the French. Now, they haven't just asked them to leave the country. They have also cancelled many contracts, many agreements, like commercial agreement, like business agreement. Let me just make you understand. In some of these ex-French colonies, the big businesses were within the hands of French companies. The big contracts of wood, of timber, of diamond, of cobalt, of whatever, within the hand of French companies. Big contracts of uranium in Niger, for instance, was within the hand of French company. In Niger, a French company had the exclusivity of buying uranium from Niger. So they come to Niger and they set the price. I'm coming to your country to buy your goods and I'm setting the price. I'm telling you at what price you're selling it to me. You're not telling the price. The good belongs to you, but I'm telling you I'm going to pay 5. I'm not paying 6 or 7. That's what was happening in the past. Now, with the military taking over these countries, they have canceled all that stuff. They have not just canceled, they've also made agreement with Russians. So the Russians have come in very strongly in Mali, Burkina Faso, and Niger. But they've come in a very fair way, like saying, okay, we can bring you infrastructure. How about that? We can bring you weapons to defend yourselves. We can give you training. And the French are not very happy about that. And that is the reason why many experts believe Emmanuel Macron is not happy. His unhappiness has absolutely nothing to do with the Russians. The unhappiness of Macron has everything to do with the fact that the Russians have come into Africa and pushing Africans into thinking freedom. You don't need the French. You have the good. You have the power. You have everything. You don't need them. And that's the reason why Macron the other day say Russia winning the war is not acceptable. They should not even think about winning the war.
We will do whatever it takes to ensure that Russia cannot win this war.
Nous ferons tout ce qu'il faut pour que la Russie ne puisse pas gagner cette guerre.
You need to ask yourself, like one of my mentors used to say, if you hear somebody going very hard on something. Why would you be capable of sending your children, your infrastructure, your resources to go and destroy it in a different country in the name of nothing? Come on. That's it, fellas. I appreciate you very much. Let me know how you feel about this. Do you think Emmanuel Macron is playing a very dangerous game? Because the Russians are very strong and they're not afraid. Do you think perhaps Macron should find a different policy? Instead of trying to fight the Russians in Ukraine, he should rather try another policy of understanding, of respect toward Africans, a policy of equal to equal, of 50-50, a policy of respect at last. God bless.